Welcome back, friends. Today video session we are going to talk about bulkhead. What is the use of bulkhead? How to implement bulkhead in a Spring Boot application? Bulkhead is a part of Resilience 4j. Resilience 4j provides two implementations of a bulkhead pattern that can be used to limit the number of concurrent execution. For example, let's say five user concurrently calling particular API, 10 user concurrently calling particular API at the same time, simultaneously calling a particular endpoint. That concurrent execution we can control. So yeah, we are going to see this demo part of our microservices only. So already I have written the code. This is a report service. A report service depends on config service and a service registry. Okay. I have already started all the services. All the services are running. Going back to report services. The report service, you can see there is a one endpoint called bulk. That endpoint annotated with at bulkhead name equal to default. Here we can pass our own configuration name. Now I'm using a default. There is a default configuration. When I go back to the configuration, see here, Resilience 4j bulkhead instances default. Since I'm using default configuration, I'm using a default. Max concurrent calls 5. Max concurrent calls 5. What I'm saying is, through this configuration, I want to call the particular API simultaneously only 5 times. Concurrently only 5 times. If more than 5 times try to call simultaneously, I want to throw some error to the client. Okay, that is the configuration. That is the meaning of this configuration. Through this configuration, I am saying this particular call, we can execute 5 times concurrently. 5 times concurrently. That is the meaning of that particular configuration. Okay. So while calling this method, I am providing some sleeping time. Thread dot flip under the millisecond. So I need to provide some delay to execute this method. Okay. Then only we can see the perfect demo of bulkhead annotation. Okay, now this call I want to execute 5 times concurrently, right? How do we test that? So we need to create a 5 different thread. Each thread act as a client. So each thread act as a client. That thread will invoke this particular API concurrently. If invoke 5 thread concurrently, that time we don't have any issue. It will invoke. If we create more than 5 thread, definitely the bulkhead never allowed to call. That is our expected output. We'll going to see that now. For that, I have created another REST application. This REST application I'm using since past 2 classes for retry purpose and rate limiter, time limiter for that, right? And for now I'm going to using bulk demo also. I'm using for bulkhead also. Okay. So here there is one more endpoint I introduced here, that is a bulk demo. Bulk demo. Here I am using a executor services to create the threads, to create the multiple threads. Okay. Multiple threads. Using executor service framework, we can easily create a threads. We can easily manage and manipulate the thread. Okay, that is the use of executor service framework. Here I am creating a 5 fixed thread pool. Okay, that meaning we can add 5 different process to this executor services, then we can execute that process concurrently. That is the meaning of this particular line. Then I created one list object. That list object contains test callable. Is my own class, one inner class. So no, it's not an inner class, it's a class. When you look at that class, it has a very simple implementation. At override string call, inside this call method I am calling my bulkhead REST API from the report services. Okay, local of 9094 API reports bulk. Look at my report service. See, this is the API I am calling. This is the API I am calling inside the test callable. Test callable. This test callable is a threat class. The test callable is a threat class. Then we can use either runnable or callable. I am using here callable. Runnable doesn't return any value. Callable returns some value. That is the difference between runnable and callable. Here I am using a callable interface. I am overriding call method. Instead of call method, I am calling the bulk REST endpoint from the report services. Okay. Going back to the code, the risk caller controller. So this list object contain test callable. Now what I am doing here in this for loop, 5 times I am iterating the for loop, right? Each iteration I am adding this test callable. So after completion of this for loop, this list object contained 5 different test callable instance. Then I want to execute these 5 test callable instance concurrently. For that, I am using executor service invoke all. I am passing this list object. Now invoke all, iterate this list object and take all the test callable method and invoke 5 instance. If 5 instance of test callable, what will happen if you invoke 5 instance of test callable? Though this method called concurrently 5 times. So our expectation is in the report service we should have a five statement concurrently. That is, this statement should print here 5 times concurrently. That is our expectation. Since we have configured in the configuration, we have configured max concurrent calls 5. It's allowed to call because there is the REST endpoint, the REST call application. I have created a 5 thread. I am calling that 5 thread concurrently. In the configuration, I mentioned max concurrent call 5. That meaning this should work perfectly. Okay, we're going to see now happy path. I'm restarting the server. Also, let me restart the report service. Yeah, the REST call application started. Report service, I think, is still not started. Report service also started. We'll go to test now. If you want to call this URL, what you have to do? The port number is 9095, right? So we have to say http://localhost/API/bulk-demo. I'm cleaning this log. Also, I'm cleaning report service log. Let's check that report service. See here, I got the 5 calls. 5 calls concurrently. Let me clean again. I'm going to call again. See, this print statement printing concurrently. When you notice this printing concurrently. Okay, it's not printing one by one. Okay, now I want to change that code, the risk call code. So here I'm going to change 10. Instead of 5, I'm going to change 10. Then I'm going to change, iterate that 10 times. So this will going to create a 10 thread pool. Now each, in this for loop, each iteration it will create a new instance of test callable. That meaning 10 test callable available inside the list. Whenever say invoke call, 10 times concurrently invoke the API. 10 times concurrently invoke this API. that mean that in that time definitely we're going to get the error, because in the configuration we have mentioned only 5 calls, concurrent calls allowed, right? Okay, let's restart the application. Okay, rest call application also started now. Now I'll go into see the demo. Now I'm going to call this API. You can see some error here now. So I got the error now. See, 4 times, then these are 5 times called. After 6th, it's not allowing you to call. It's giving some error. Let's see what is the error. Bulkhead default is full and does not permit further call. Because in the configuration, I have mentioned only 5 calls, but we are trying to call 10 concurrent calls. That's the reason it's providing the error. Okay. Now we're going to make the dynamic. Okay. Let me open rest call. I want to keep increase. I want to make this number as a dynamic. As of now, this is static, right? What we can do for that? Create a request param. Task integer task, then I want to pop this task here, then I want to pop this task here. Okay, now in the parameter I can pass how many concurrent call you want to call, particular test method, particular this risk call method. Okay, if you pass 1, it will call 1 time. It will pass 2, it will call 2 times, 2 concurrents. If pass 3, it will call 3 concurrents. Okay, up to 5, it should work. If you pass more than 5, pass 6, if you pass 7, definitely it will not work. It will provide it will throw the error. That is our expectation. Okay, now it will go to restart the application. Application started. Report service. I'm cleaning this log. Clear all. Okay. Now, what I will do? I need to pass parameter, right? This time. Okay. Task equal to 1. I am saying 1. What happened? Bulkhead demo task equal to 1. Hey, why this is local of API task equal to 1. Okay, see I passed parameter 1, so it's called 1 time, one instance of callable get executed, created, and it's called 1 time. Now I want to do 2 concurrent call. See, now it's a 2. Let me clear this. Now I want to give 3. Now 3 times called. Now I want to provide 4. Let me clean this log before that. I want to provide 4 concurrent call. See, 4 time. Now I want to provide 5. Let me clean this. See, 5 concurrent call. Now I want to provide 6. This time you should give error, because in configuration I mentioned only 5, right? Now I am providing 6 concurrent call. Six. See here, 5 times called, then 6th time it's providing error. bulkhead default is full and does not permit further call. Okay, this is the usage of bulkhead, guys. Okay, let me change configuration name. My calls. I'm changing my calls. Then go to config repo. Change this to my call. Then commit the code. Since we are using microservice, we have to commit the code. Okay, commit and push because of configuration reading from configuration file. Config service, our configuration reading from config service. So we have to commit and push. Okay, I'll going to restart the report service now. Okay, so our is started, report service started now. Let's check the demo. Okay, now I'll going to call 6 only. I want to see that our configuration is working or not. I got the error because I called it 6 times. So now it says my bulkhead my calls because I mentioned my calls as my configuration. Okay, if you want, you can use fallback method also. I want to provide some proper response. In that case, we can use fallback method. Show error. Please follow this method signature. Then you can, whenever throws the error, this method get executed. Okay. So far, we have completed everything, most of the stuff. According to this architecture, we have implemented API gateway, account service, product service, report service, connecting DB to account service and a product service. We have implemented config server, service registry, also circuit breaker, that is fault tolerance. I'm closing the fault tolerance, the session. By today, okay, from the next session onwards, you're going to see Spring Cloud Sleuth. Okay, that is a distributed tracking, sorry, distributed tracing. How to trace the calls across the services. That topic we're going to see from the next class. Okay, after completion of that, I'll going to deploy the same architecture in Amazon AWS. Okay, if you have any question, please post a question in the comment section. Definitely I'll going to give an answer. See all the source code available in the GitHub. Please take it from there. I have given the downloadable link. I have given the source code as well as configuration repo configuration also available in the GitHub. Take it from there. Okay, until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.